get ready to match the stars. George Kennedy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty Duke Aston, from Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch, as we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now, here's the star of match game, PM, Gene Rivers.
How are you? Thank you for joining us here on Match Game PM. We're going to have a grand time because we have the beautiful, humorous people here with us. And over here on my right, we have our two civilians, Jeff Jackson and Jerry Ann Delgado. Well, before we begin, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. What are you laughing at, Jerry Ann?
Nothing.
Shall we begin with you?
All right.
All right. Let's begin with you.
Okay. I have a 2-year-old boy named Sean. He's everything to me. And I attend Cerritos College full-time, and I'm an amateur potter there. I want to be a natural childbirth coach, and I work for LA Unified Schools as a teacher's aide at State Street Children's Center, and that's my life story.
Yes. Isn't that interesting? I mean, how do you go from being an amateur potter to a professional potter?
You work hard at it.
You work hard.
Yeah,
yeah.
You throw
right.
A lot of pot.
Colette.
Whoa.
Jerry Ann, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Now, you, sir, tell us about you.
I was born in Canton, Ohio, and raised in a town not far from there called Hartville, Ohio.
You sure don't sound like a Midwesterner to me.
Well, I've been in Los Angeles now about 3 years.
Oh, that's
so
why
I
you
guess
talk
I've,
funny.
I guess. The smog.
That's right.
That's right.
And what do you do, Jeff?
Currently, I'm in between opportunities, let's say.
You're not alone there.
Well, if you had an opportunity, what would you like to do, Jeff?
Take it.
Take it.
Thank you very much.
Now, here on Match Game PM, each of you will have 3 opportunities to match as many of the creatures from the Dark Lagoon as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. Go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. All right, here we go. Jerry Ann, you may have A or B.
B, please.
Jerry Ann says she wants B, and this is it. 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle is so old, he even gets winded when he plays blank. 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle is so old, he even gets winded when he plays blank.
I love my answer. I love my answer.
Oh, there are a couple of good ones that I've thought of for this one. Here it is. 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle is so old, he even gets winded when he plays blank.
Shuffleboard.
Shuffleboard.
Don't. That was, I don't know.
Yeah.
Couldn't I know think Mr. Of... Periwinkle, but I just, gosh.
Uh-huh. All right. Now, some good answers are going to come up over here, Jerry Ann. Listen carefully. It'll give you some
any
guidance.
Satisfaction to you. This isn't one of them. The television set.
Well, that's okay. No, I think that's a good answer. Anything that requires no exertion or energy
or
would
no
be a good answer, you see. What do you say?
I said he even gets exhausted when he plays doctor.
Don't you love it?
You rascal. Hello, Chuck.
Hey.
Ah, what?
When he plays the radio.
All right, that's in his genre there. I think those are good answers up there. Let's see what we get down here. Patty, Mr. Periwinkle's so old, he even gets winded when he plays...
Bridge. Or hit his bridge, I don't know.
I see. Either way, yeah.
He gets winded when he crosses... Well, we'll come to that. Bridge.
Bridge. All right. You got the idea now, Jerry Ann.
Yeah.
Now, here we come.
Yes?
She'll give you a conventional answer every time. May we see it, please?
I said he even gets winded when he plays dead.
Okay. All right, Mr. Opportunity, here it is. After it was run over by a steamroller, Norman was able to slip his blank under the door. Jeff, are you thinking?
I'm thinking.
All right. After it was run over by a steamroller, Norman was able to slip his blank under the door.
Foot.
Foot. Well, at least we've got a matched pair, haven't we?
I have a lot of opportunities to come to play. Just does not recognize them.
Well, that's sure. that's like Jerry Ann's question. It adds 100,000 answers. It could have been foot. I got head.
All right. Slipped his head under the door. That's okay, Brett.
Oh, I got it all on his whole body.
His whole body. Okay. What do you come up with here?
I think I put this good outfit on for this. Arm and hand.
Arm and hand. That's your good outfit? That's you. Oh, we're just one big happy family. After it was run over by steamroller, Norm was able to slip his blank under the door. What do you say to that?
I wanted to bring a little class to the show. His butt. I liked his butt.
Right. She said butt. B-U-double-T.
No what? Legs, hands, or...
Yeah.
I said car.
Car. Yeah. Okay. Well, it's a wide-ranging question. Patty?
Not really. I said his former car. Right.
His former car. Okay, there we are at the end of round one. We haven't scored yet. We hope to score a little bit later, but right now, this. Now, everybody who appears in this program gets the home version of the match game. Isn't that wonderful? Okay, we go to round two. Now, Jerry M. went first last time, so Jeff will ask you to go first this time.
I will pick A, please.
All right. You've got it. Marge said to the psychiatrist, "Doc, my husband's got a problem. He keeps going round and round and round. He thinks he's a blank."
Got it.
Marge is speaking to the psychiatrist. She says, "Doc, my husband's got a problem. He keeps going round and round and round. He thinks he's a blank." All right, while Charles is writing, you finish, Charles. Yes. Marge said to the psychiatrist, "Doc, my husband's got a problem. He keeps going round and round and round. He thinks he's a blank."
A merry-go-round?
A merry-go-round. George, show us yours.
A carousal.
Carousel is a merry-go-round. That's one for Jeff. What do you say?
What is that?
Knock, knock.
That's opportunity knocking.
Oh.
Merry-go-round.
Oh.
Thank you.
I was going to put Sonia Hennydahl, but no one would understand it. Merry-go-round.
Well, things are looking up for Jeff, Patty.
No, they're not.
No?
Record.
A record. That's another good choice.
That's it.
Yes.
Carousel.
Carousel. Four for him. What do you offer, my dear?
A hula hoop.
A hula hoop. Yeah. I remember those. So there you are. Hey, you did very well with your round two question. Now let's see how Jerry Ann does with hers. Jerry Ann Delgado. Isn't that a pretty name?
Gorgeous.
During the operation, the surgeon said to the nurse, "This patient has obviously eaten an overdose of hot peppers. As you can see, his blank is melting." The surgeon is speaking to the nurse during the operation. Said, "This patient obviously has eaten an overdose of hot peppers. As you can see, his blank is melting."
Could you repeat the whole?
Sure, I'll repeat the whole thing slowly for you. Do not respond until I tell you to, all right? Because some of them may still be writing.
I won't.
During the operation, the surgeon said to the nurse, "Nurse, this patient has obviously eaten an overdose of hot peppers. As you can see, his blank is melting." Don't say it. Finish, Brett?
I'm finished, hon.
Okay, say it.
Stomach.
Stomach?
All right.
Not a bad answer. He could have been performing a simple laparotomy. And,
That's a gotcha.
All right.
Laparotomy, yeah. That's one for her.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought those hot peppers went straight for your liver.
Liver? What do you say? All right.
Stomach.
Stomach. Yeah. So that score is now 4-2. Patty Duke, eat an overdose of hot peppers, you can see his stomach is melting.
Yes.
It is indeed. 4-3. Show us your stomach.
Okay.
Saw it.
Peek-a-boo. Here's the medical term, innards.
Innards. Yeah.
Oh, come on now.
Wait a minute, now, hold on. Innards, I think, innards could refer to everything.
I swear.
It could refer to the gallbladder and to the lungs and the liver and to the, all that stuff there.
What did I write?
What's that? The pancreas and the spleen, too, could get
in the
act.
Well, up your pancreas, and I'll help you fall on your spleen.
Now let's go to your answer, Patty Deutsch.
Huh?
You.
Oh, me.
You have a turn.
Yo, I said blue cross card.
Blue cross card. Blue cross card. All right, 4-3. We go to round 3. This is the final round. Jeff, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first.
I will pick A again, please.
You will. All right. Anything you say, Jeff. Let's see, who plays?
Yes.
I don't.
Chicken in red.
Oh, yeah, the lady in red and the lady in silk. Are you ready? Bob said that new judge sure gets confused easily. At the end of the murder trial, he told them to hang the blank.
I like that one.
New judge sure gets confused easily. At the end of the murder trial, he told them to hang the blank.
I've got a perfect answer for that one. I wish I were playing.
Bob said, that new judge sure gets confused easily. At the end of the murder trial, he told them to hang the blank.
Jury.
Says jury. He said, hang the jury. What do you say?
Hang the jury.
Hang the jury. All right, what do you say?
Jury.
Hang the jury. Ho, ho, ho. Now, Jerry Ann, you got a match of 3 remaining ones you haven't matched so far to achieve a tie and stay in the game. That's Brett, Richard, and Patty Deutsch will play. Kate said, my husband thinks he's a dog, and I'm beginning to believe him. Last night, he brought home a blank. Light your light, Brett.
My light's lit. Or I am, one or the other. I never can remember.
Kate said, my husband thinks he's a dog, and I'm beginning to believe him. Last night, he brought home a blank.
Bone.
Bone. She's looking for a bone. She needs 3 bones to achieve a tie and stay in the game.
Well, there's no need to get cranky.
Remember what I told you when he wears a gray or a green suit?
Yes,
that's the
exactly.
Kind of cantankerous remark.
Sounds like Clarence.
I'm the same sweet, lovable person I've always been, no matter what I wear. Show us your card.
It's not an interrogation, you know. It's just a simple question.
Show us your card. Bone.
Would you please kindly show us your card, sir?
It's really a waste of time. I already matched her with innards and stomach. But to prove I can continue to do this, bone.
Bone it is, 465. Little lady wants a bone.
Have you ever seen such pain on a person's face?
That's
knowing
right.
Knowing it's up to me. Mm. Bone.
Bone, tie a score. Okay. Now we'll tell you what happens when we have a tie, right after we tell you about this. Now, we don't have time to play our regular tiebreaker, so what we're going to do is play Sudden Death. And the first one of you to score a match will be the winner. We have 1 tie-breaking question here for both of you, and you'll be playing with our 3 regulars, Brett, Charles, and Richard. And you two will write your answers, and the celebrities will give us verbal responses. And here it is. Write your response to this. Marriage blank. Marriage blank. All right, got him in the slot there. And here we go. Now, if you hear your answer over here, jump up and down and sing Dixie or something like that. Brett, what is your response? Marriage blank.
The whole world needs marriage counselor.
Marriage counselor, do either one of you have that? No.
Nope.
Charles, what is your response to this?
Marriage vows.
Vows. Do we have vows over there? All right, Richard, we've come to you. Marriage blank.
Ceremony.
Ceremony! Jerry Ann has got it. Okay. Hang around over here.
license.
He had marriage license. They both had good answers. Jerry Ann is the winner. Jeff will have some gifts for you, together with our thanks for being here on Match Game PM. So long, Jeff. Just hang around here, because here it is. We've got an opportunity here for you to earn over $10,000. Now, to do that, we're going to have two audience matches for you here. And I want to point out to you, Jerry Ann, whatever you win in these audience matches will be multiplied by 10, and that'll be the final dollar figure you will be playing for. Here we go. We polled a studio audience not too long ago in this very room, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank my back. Now, the answer they wrote down most frequently will get you $500 if you match it, $250 for matching the second most popular answer, and $100 for matching the third. Three of our six celebrities will help.
Richard.
Something I'd like you to do, scratch my back.
Okay. Brett. Yes.
Something I've wanted Charles to do for years, get off my back.
And Charles.
Behind your back.
Behind your back, scratch my back, and get off my back. Those are the three. Your option now is to choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I'll go with Richard and scratch his back.
Scratch his back.
Scratch my back.
All right. Scratch my back or his back or anyway. Scratch my back. Right here is where it itches. Thank you very much. Okay. We're looking for scratch my back. May we see the $100 response? Oh, my back. It's oh, my aching back. Yeah, that's the way we all used to say it. May we see the next one, please? Scratch my back is the one she chose. Congratulations. What do you think's under the big one? Get off my back. Slide it, Ori. Get off my back. They were right.
Oh, thank you.
All right, that's the one the Brett gave you. Get off my back. Now, you've won $250, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. Now, let's see how much more you're going to win, Jerry Ann, with our second audience match. Go. Garlic blank. Garlic blank.
Richard.
Bread. Garlic,
garlic
bread.
Garlic bread.
George.
What was the first one?
Garlic.
Garlic
bread.
Bread is what Richard said.
Garlic breath.
You say garlic breath.
That's a good answer.
Yeah.
Patty.
Oh. Yeah, wait a minute. Oh. Something might come from Bob.
You clove. Get an idea.
Garlic clove.
Clove. So you have the three there. Garlic clove, garlic bread, and garlic breath. Again, you have a choice of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
Bread.
You want garlic bread. All right, was Richard's answer. Let's find out if it's up there and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Garlic salt.
Oh, yeah.
Not a bad answer.
Yeah,
that is interesting. Very interesting. We're looking for garlic bread. Slide it, please. Garlic breath.
Very good.
Getting close to bread, aren't we? Is the bread up there?
Yeah.
Show us your bread. You got it. Yeah. You won another $500. Multiplied by 10 is $5,000. Added to the previous pot of $2,500 gives you a pot of $7,500 to shoot for. And we'll give you the money if you'll match one of them exactly.
Richard.
Here we go. For $7,500. Good luck to you. It reads like this. Blank camera. Blank camera. Blank camera. Now, he's finished, Jerry Ann. Give us the answer that matches his. We give you $7,500.
Brownie. Oh, I couldn't think of anything. There's so many different kinds of cameras. And...
You can't. Brownie camera is your answer.
Yeah, I don't know why.
You don't know why?
No.
I don't either. Richard, she says, brownie camera will match you for $7,500. What do you say?
With that smile that you have, I could not believe you wouldn't say.
Smile, you're on Candid Camera.
Oh, I didn't even
think about that.
You didn't
think about that?
No.
Well, I'm sorry.
I don't watch it. I, you know.
Oh, well.
So I don't.
Nothing personal, Alan. Doesn't like your show? Well, I'm sorry. We can't give you the money, but it wasn't a total loss because you have a grand amount of money here of $750. Congratulations, Jerry Ann. Now we've got this for you. Little unfinished business before we go here. George Kennedy has a movie that's going to be out very soon called Death on the Nile. Who's in that?
I played the title role.
You play death.
No, Peter Ustinov. This is one of the Agatha Christie novels.
Yeah.
And Peter Ustinov plays Poirot and David Niven and Betty Davis, Mia Farrow, a bunch of lightweights.
Oh, yeah. We'll look forward to seeing that. Now, who is that plays the starring role in your film called Family Fudd?
I do.
You play the starring role?
Yep.
Are you Richard Dawson?
I'm the same person who wrote Stomach and changed it for Inner. And I'll never forget.
Well, what the producer is saying to you is, what came up there? Get off my back. It's one of the answers that came up there.
Okay.
And after the show, you can kiss and make up. Everything's going to be all
right. I will not make up.
Well, he's not a bad kisser.
Oh, in that case, maybe I will.
Oh, okay. I'm Gene Rayburn. Hope you'll join us next time for Match Game PM. Goodbye.